So it's my pleasure to introduce Maria Rosa with the paper Leibniz Reconception of Manolis' Work. So please.
Good morning. I wish to say many thanks to the organizer for making possible this celebration and for inviting me. I am very, very happy to be here. For me, Professor Mulock is my professor, my mentor, my teacher. I learned and I have learned a lot with Professor Knobloch from history of mathematics, from Leibniz, with his comments, his questions, since 1905. In film, in the history of lecture organized by Professor Knobloch and Professor Chimla and Jean-Pierre. There, after my intervention on Mengele's theory of ratios of ratios, Professor Knobloch you have made an important presentation. You must read Leibniz manuscripts or Leibniz correspondence because Leibniz quoted a lot Mengele's work. For this reason, I have chosen this subject, Leibniz reception of Mengele's work. I hope you like this. At the end, we return to make a photos to the Barcelona, from Barcelona, from people of Barcelona. Professor Knobloch. The aim of this contribution is to reflect on the Leibniz reception of Mengele's work on quadrature only. Context, Mengele's works quoted by Leibniz correspondence, Leibniz excerpts from Mengele's circles on 17th century, the articulation of algebra and geometry, the introduction of infinity procedures, and the process. The process of algebraization of mathematics. In this period, thanks to the circulation of Liebig's work, Bergman's works, and overall Descartes, geometry, other authors like John Wallis, Pietro Mengele, or Leibniz began to use these procedures to solve quadrature problems and also to approximate the quadrature of the circle. Mengele take a source, Biet, directly, as he says, continually. Erigone, there is elements Clavius, elements Euclid take by Clavius, and Mengele use Euclid's Clavius. And the geometry of indivisible of Cavalieri is his mentor, his teacher. The three works about quadrature. Nove Quadrature Aritmeticae, 1650. Geometria Speciosa de Mena, 1659. And Circolo, 1672. The most quoted is Nove Quadrature Arimathizae, 1650. In the Nove Quadrature Arimathizae, in the Prefacio, he says, Nicoli, after much meditation on Archimedes' quadrature of the parabola, in which infinitely many triangles being in continuous quadruple proportion do not exceed certain limited quantities, the universal quadrature, on we interpret the universal quadrature, the quadrature of the circle, and later in Circulo he says, he quotes Nove Quadrature Arimathizae as Susa for the quadrature of the circle. In the preface, there is the demonstration, memory shows the divergence of the harmonic series by an original person. This demonstration sparked a discussion among his European contemporaries, above all between Oldenburg and Leibniz. And Leibniz finally says, ingenious, the divergence of harmonic series. Says the preface, the work consists of three books, where the results are ordinates in increasing order or difficulty. In the first book, he deals with series of fractions, with denominators, plans, mainly 1/2, 1/6, etc. And he proves that the infinity summation is 1. Later, in the Lamentum Sextum on Geometria, after showing the quadratures by indivisibles, he used this proposition, this novae, to calculate quadratures through this summation. The same for the proposition N. He made also in the Elementum Sextum to make this. The discussion is about Mengele and Oldenburg, Leibniz and Oldenburg, is if the summation are finite or are infinite. Leibniz to Oldenburg. As to the sumus fractions, denominators of which are triangular, piramidal, which you suggest were begun by Mengele, I reply thus. As Mengele's book is not to hand, it seems from your account, Collins, that Mengele only gave the sum of such fractions in a finite series. For example, whereas, mientras, I had actually found the sum of the whole infinite series, which I do not think to have been forbidden by me, by him, because the illustrious Huygens propounded the problem. I actually found a universal solution by which, to the surprise of Huygens himself, I get the sums of not only infinite triangular fractions, but also infinite pyramidals. Yet, if Mengele has done the same thing, I shall not be astonished, because different people commonly fall into the discussion. This finish of this. The second work is Geometria Speciosa Elementa, 1659. 462-page text in pure mathematics is very, very hard, this book. But this book, Collins sent to Barrow, and Barrow, after return the book, he says, is more difficult than learn the Arabic. Because Geometria Specious Elementa is make algebra in the geometry. Make a symbolism, make a procedure, and Barrow don't understand or don't understand, but don't seem interested. In fact, mainly unintentionally, create a new file, a specious geometry. That means symbols used to represent not just numbers, but also values of any abstract mind. Mengele made the sums of powers with letters and calculated the sums of powers. The triangular tables of sums, he makes in triangular tables. The quasi-proportions, today we say the limits, the quasi-proportions. The logarithms of ratios, the system of coordinates, the geometric figures presented by algebraic expressions in triangular tables, and also the quadrature of these geometric figures. In fact, this expression is Mengele's expression, but is integral between 0, 1, x, m, 1 less x, m. Is this expression. He says, form of all products of m abscissa and n remainders. Geometria Specious Elementa is mentioned on logarithms in a letter from Oldenburg to Leibniz. For this reason, I think Leibniz knows Geometria Specious Elementa, the part of logarithms. The part of logarithms, I think Leibniz knows. The other parts, I'm not sure. See? Moreover, Mengele, in the preface of the Geometria Specious printed at Bologna, concerning making logarithms proportionally to those in common use, say that if you will make the logarithm of any number, as supposed to assume any rank of fractions, the more the better, whereof the denominator is, I think, when Leibniz read the circolo and explain about logarithms, he make the explanation of Mengele. He understand the logarithms. In the letter dedicatory of Elementum Sextum, Mengele calculate these quadratures, the quadratures that I say, by indivisibles. He said that he knew these quadratures since 1647. And now he tried to sum this quadrature for finding another quadrature, like Archimedes, using the summation of the infinite series making the bar. In the Elementum Sextum, he calculates many quadratures which he already knew with new and secure foundations. And he says, I knew and I go to find new foundations. For the method of indivisibles or for other methods equivalents. I am not sure that Leibniz read the quadratures in manual geometry. This is the quadratures. Is you can see he makes the expressions of geometric figures in forma de taula. He classifies the figures, the increasing, the decreasing. He found the maximum in the figures, in these figures, in this x by one plus x. And this is my drawings. Eh? It's not drawings. Eh? It's not drawings. Only in geometria speciosa, only in the demonstration one. Inscripts, circumscripts, all. Circolo. Circolo, we have the serps. Leibniz, a serps, I see. Leibniz make a text. You can see at the beginning, since my youth, I have been researching the problem of the quadrature of the circle, the most so after that. As I say in the preface to my book on arithmetic quadratures in the year 1650, I found it after completing the book of elements of specious geometry, which I printed in 1659, the following year, 1660. Is the three works is connected. Also, at the beginning, he says, I therefore propose to clarify the quadrature of the circle and countless many quadratures that, to my knowledge, have never before been found or attempted by any geometer. Okay, and he makes this point. Leibniz a serp in 1676, there is three parts in this Leibniz a serp. There is one first part in difference Volgen Reichen and 2003 and arithmetic Gresh quadrature into I go to talk about this. There is the other, but I have published Sigmund Brons also have published that is. Begin at the beginning of Circolo, he mainly construct the triangle. This triangle, we say harmonic triangle. He makes the multiply the term by two, three term by three, and then he made the inverse. And all this triangle, this harmonic triangle, is the quadrature. Are the quadratures of the figures that he busca. Look for. Sorry. And then he make his interpretation this result. The result is the carré homolog al unity. The triangle homologo and half. and the other homólogo a la parte de la mitad tersa, sexta y tersa. Mengolin. The same Linus in this excerpt, he made a figure. In the circle of Mengolin, there is no figure, any figure. He makes a figure. I think he makes a figure for the understanding of people, I think is well, but he didn't say that Mengele don't put the figures. And this figure, and he makes the same with only one figure, or the names. Do you remind that Linus made the X in vertical and the horizontal the I. Hello? I don't. He egal Caesar. If you met one, is I don't see señal, perquè m'he rarió. No, així, aquí. This part is the manuscript. The manuscript that I have taught, the tables, and this is the table interpolation. He makes interpolation for circle. Interpolate tabula formosa. He makes this expression que és in a R mayúscula is carré. Is R. This de la Linus, he makes ordinates. Ordinates also square root. What is the circolo? The circolo is this. This is the carré X by one less X. The solution, the values of these quadratures. Also, he calculate the values of these quadratures, and he make, I don't know if you see this, there is integral between 0 and 1 square 1 less x square. See? And then all values of this interpolate harmonic triangle represent the values of the quadratures. And he circolo, in English circolo, he calculate these values. He calculate these values. Linus did not say anything of these results. He made again one figure, and he made the interpretation about the figure. And the calculation of number P, is the other part of the Mengele circle, begins with the combinatorial piano. And line is what Mengoli. So far I have extracted from Mengoli his general method, which he used to square, keep, read, with word, the Mengoli still. He construed also the series, the sequence of numbers. He also put the text rhetorical is similar to Mengoli's text, the product, infinite product, also, like this. Also, he makes the space minor and space major, circular. For me, it's more didactic than this, than Mengoli. Linus read Mengoli, but Linus is more didactic. It is clear the circumscribed square as one, the inscribed square as 1/2. And also, when logarithms, Linus makes the same explanation than Mengoli. And Mengoli quotes elemento di geometria speciosa. And also, Linus make an addition, nota bene, a new series of rational numbers equal to the circle may therefore be derived, taken from the difference of the cycles, space, and joining corresponding difference from two series of hypercycles and hypercycles, you have the sum of all absolutely. You can also join this difference of the hypercycles and hypercycles to the corresponding difference of the bigger and small space. And the resulting series will be either equal to the circle or absolutely quadratic. It's very interesting this point, the space, one space, the other space with the similar less, etc. Aquí está. Bom. Well, I wish to finish only and say that Leibniz read well Mengoli. You are reason as like to like sempre like to you, but I go to show the photos the Barcelona. I less this point. Lenin added nota bene, added the drawings, and with Arilés, we go to manuscripts of 1679, and I think there is other things. There's here.